What is up, you guys? Nick here, and in today's video, I want to go over the top three EV picks for right now. I want to do a deep dive on the electric vehicle industry as a whole, and especially those EV companies based out of China. I want to discuss why this broad market correction has been taking place, and if you should harness it or wait for a more stable time to come. I'll be highlighting three fantastic EV stocks that I think have exceptionally high upside to add to your portfolio and why that is. With the House of Representatives unanimously passing the bill to upload the Holding Foreign Companies Accountable Act, things may change heading into next year, and I want to analyze the potential impacts this may have on the future of Chinese companies listed on American exchanges. But first, Webull is an amazing 0% commission stock trading platform with a brand new promo offering 4 free stocks worth up to $3,700. For free, when you 1, sign up, 2, open an account, and 3, deposit at least $100 into your brokerage account using the link in my description. This is an absolute no-brainer. The promo ends soon, guys. Do not sleep on it. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. I'd really appreciate it. I'm keeping all of my subscribers up to date with all the movements in the EV industry, and I focus on emerging innovative disruptor companies. Decimate that like button for the YouTube algorithm, hit the notification bell, and without further ado, let's get right into it. All right, long-term gang. First, I want to move into the Chinese electric vehicle responses to the Holding Foreign Companies Accountable Act. So historically, Chinese companies would commit acts of fraud as oversight on their filings were minimal, to say the least. With the new bill having passed, Chinese companies will now have to comply with the Public Company Accounting Oversight Board's, the PCAOB, full auditing rules and regulations within a 3-year time period. Chinese electric vehicle stocks have been shuttered by this news, compounded by a prominent short seller, instilling fear into American investors, and lastly, profit taking occurring. There is so much volatility and movement within these shares that unbelievable windows of opportunity have opened within minutes and closed just as fast. We saw this take place perfectly during December 2nd's trading period off opening bell. NIO shares dropped over 10% and recovered to an actual substantial gain day in the green. These openings and closings will be ever increasing in the coming weeks as uncertainty grows. However, will these companies be able to comply with the required audit reports within 3 years? Well, there are certain companies who are hesitant, and other companies who are extremely optimistic. Let's dive in a bit deeper. Li Auto, one of the newest Chinese electric vehicle companies to jump on board US exchanges, is shockingly quite outwardly concerned regarding the situation and their future viability upon US exchanges. In their prospectus, they quote, "The adoption of any rules, legislations, or other efforts to increase US regulatory access to audit information could cause uncertainty, and we could be delisted if we are unable to meet the PCAOB's inspection requirement in time." I was actually quite personally shocked by this bluntness and harsh reality of the statement. I do think it was this particular statement that prevented Li from having the bounce back that was enjoyed by other similar EV competitors. If this sentiment continues to be expressed from the Li Auto camp, I would not doubt a continually and rapidly falling share price continuing in the coming weeks and months. Now, what is interesting about this is that Li Auto, in general, is actually performing quite well. And although it is not getting quite the same spotlight like some of its rivals like NIO, they are quietly pulling up their sales to impressive numbers. In Q2 2020 alone, they delivered 6,604 vehicles and increased this to 8,660 in Q3 2020. They have a 2020 calendar year total of 26,498 thus far. This is very impressive considering just how new of a company they are. They produced over 5,000 units within the month of November, practically catching up to NIO's current output, and have supposedly even higher demand than supply, a common story amongst electric vehicle startups currently. Now, I want to preface that I do not think these companies will risk being delisted from US exchanges in 3 years' time. There is simply too much liquidity coming from North American investors to not comply with all auditing rules and regulations from US exchanges. Now, that being said, if these stocks can continue decreasing in value in the coming weeks due to the growing fear of delisting, I do think this will work out to investors' advantages who are able to seize the moment and buy when the masses are selling. Many investors of Chinese EV are pulling their capital and moving it towards American, more backed and secured companies like Tesla. Just look at Tesla's insane trading volume over the past few weeks. Granted, this is inclusion into the S&P 500 being priced in as well. For me personally, these past few days have been strong buying days, as I do believe in the future of Chinese electric vehicle companies and their ability to continue growing and expanding. Don't forget, China is the largest producer and consumer of electric vehicles in the world, and by huge margins at that. The demand is there, And these young companies are growing their roots to establish themselves as giants in the industry in the coming years. I do think that Li Auto, with its quietly growing deliveries, its relatively lower share price, and its future expansion programs, make this a great long-term buy and hold. If Growing Concern can pull this stock beneath the $30 mark yet again, I will indeed be buying additional shares. All right, moving into number two. NIO. So unlike Li Auto, who outwardly expressed concern, NIO actually took virtually the exact opposite approach. A NIO spokeswoman in an interview with Barron expressed that they were aware of this situation in the summer months and actually began complying with all audits, rules, and regulations following this. They were aware that this bill would likely be passed, as it had been a growing concern in the House of Representatives and had bipartisan backing. It was because of this and the forecasted investor fright and anxiety that they quietly became compliant over the past few months. It's also important to note that this isn't an immediate issue. These companies have 3 years to comply. 3 years. This is an extremely long time, and investors' memories are extremely short. Although this anxiety and uncertainty is currently priced into the share price, pulling it down, fast forward 3-4 months down the line, and I can virtually guarantee this will be a memory of the past as companies roll into their Q4 earnings and expand in the emerging economy. However, I do think NIO will have increased volatility in comparison to some of the other EV manufacturers in the coming weeks. It has recently shot into the spotlight and has by far the heaviest 5-day moving averages of the three stocks. It has recently been the most traded stock on the NYSE, however, without being vertically integrated, compounded by this recent anxiety, has sent this stock on a roller coaster ride. Now, what do I continue to preach, time and time again? If you believe in the long-term potential of a company, do not let day-to-day or hour-to-hour fluctuations rule your choices. Zoom out. This company has so many massive prospects and expansion plans set for early 2021. They continue increasing deliveries, and their JAC-centered headquarters is poised to output 7,500 vehicles a month by early 2021. If we even come close to this number, investors will eat up the stock and a resulting surge in share price will ensue. We have seen other uncertainty periods with other big name EV companies like Tesla. Do you remember those days? In early September, Tesla lost 33% in valuation. However, from that low, is now up 80%. Stocks, and especially those in the limelight, typically follow cyclical patterns of mass selling and then buying. So although extremely volatile, with high highs and low lows, these stocks propose intense valuation prospects over the long term. Remember, the old adage, buy low, sell high, baby. In this case, never sell because it's NIO. What up, long-term gang? I am continually buying NIO shares on dip days as I really do see huge promise from this company moving into NIO Day and the unveiling of their first sedan model, the EE7. Lastly, I want to highlight XPeng. Now, this company has been the most quiet concerning the potential delisting compared to any other Chinese electric vehicle, and I will have a video update once their stance is made more clear. I am not quite sure why they have not yet replied to this growing anxiety. However, their share price is mostly reacting similar to other industry competitors. Now, why is XPeng now one of the most expensive Chinese EV stocks? Well, it's actually because they are completely vertically integrated. Many investors are banking on the fact that XPeng actually owns their own factories with absolutely insane output capacity, of which they are nowhere close to even reaching. Unlike NIO and Li Auto, who are literally pushing the limits of their current output production, XPeng took a drastically different approach in their early days by building their own manufacturing plant at high scale early on in their lifespan, and is currently building another huge megafactory. They're staying well above their capacity, showing both their intense belief they will be able to grow, their margins will be able to recover much quicker, and their spending will only decrease in the coming quarters. Investors also like that they already have a sedan on the market, the P7, which has been a hit with consumers within China. It is both more affordable than industry competitors and is equipped with some of the best autonomous driving software in all of China. They're striving to be the first company with complete L4 driverless technology in their vehicles, of which they pre-equipped the P7 to be capable of handling before the technology even caught up. A massive move and insight by the company. Their deliveries are quietly expanding, and I do think this current share price is a complete fire sale. I also do not think that investors have priced in this recent surge in their deliveries month over month. This has been completely overshadowed by exterior news, and I do think once this is fully realized, their share price will once again surge. Now, I do want to make it clear that I am currently invested in all three of these companies. I see huge upside in the EV market, and especially within these young companies based out of China. I by no means think it's deleterious to hold multiple industry rivals in your portfolio to further micro-diversify. These companies, although within the same industry, operate in almost completely different spectrums. XPeng, more akin to Tesla being vertically integrated, and NIO taking a path of its own and using an outsourcing model that has thus proved many naysayers of its viability wrong. They continue to grow. I will be keeping exceptionally close eyes on these companies moving forward, so make sure you hit that subscribe button. Do not forget about the Webull promo. It is a truly awesome deal for free stocks worth up to $3,700. You can't ask for better. Anyways, thanks so much for watching, everyone. I really do appreciate the continued support. What a community this is. Let me know how you feel about these companies in the comments. Are you buying, selling, holding? What are you doing, y'all? Anyways, long-term gang, I will see you all in the next video. Hit the like button for the YouTube algorithm. Cheers.